home players, Endo and Hawakawa. Well, this is the women's singles draw. The two-time world champion, Carolina Marin of Spain, the number one seed. And as I say, Li Xuerui won the title last year, 2 years ago. As a qualifier, Akane Yamaguchi won. Wang Yihan, who's in the bottom half of the draw, you can see, against Tai Su Ying. They've both been former champions. Wang Yihan, in fact, has three times won the title here, and Tai Su Ying won in 2012. That's absolutely extraordinary, isn't it, that we've got so many former champions still in the draw at quarterfinal stage. And of course, Japan are guaranteed a semi-finalist, because there's an all-Japanese affair at the bottom part of the draw, because Mitani put out the current world number one, Saina Nehwal, number one, number two seed here, though, of India, put her out yesterday. And Okuhara, former world junior champion, put out former world champion Ratchanuk Intanon in three games. There was plenty of upsets yesterday in the women's singles draw, as indeed there have in many a tournament, recent tournament. So many people criticising the women's singles discipline, saying it was all dominated by China. Not a bit of it. It's the most exciting event in the world of badminton right now, in my humble opinion. So the Olympic champion and defending champion here at the Yonex Open Japan, Li Xuerui, the number three seed, up against the teenager Akane Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi, as you can see, not seeded, despite being number 10 on the world ranking. Just 18 years of age. Born in Fukui. And 2 years ago came through the qualifying to win her home Super Series event in only her fifth international tournament at senior level. Became the youngest ever winner of a Super Series title, aged 16 years, 3 months and 16 days. And she still holds that record. But here is the Olympic champion, number three seed, defending champion, Li Xuerui. Chinese player, 24 years of age, from Chongqing in Sichuan province. Number four in the world ranking at the moment, a total of 123 weeks as world number one, 118 of those consecutive weeks. But her form has dropped, and she will be very eager to put the record straight and say she is a very much a contender. Now, first round match, she was given a walkover by the bronze medalist from the recent World Championships, Linda Wenny Funnetree. And then yesterday against Kaori Imabepu of Japan. Had to save three game points in that second game before eventually winning it, 23-21. So here is the 18-year-old two-time world junior champion. Didn't play in the recent World Championships because she was playing a high school team competition. Seems a strange choice to me, but then there we go. She's only 18. She's got plenty more World Championships to come. Been in two Super Series tournament finals, not only winning here in Japan, but reached the final of the premier event in China last year. And what a result in the very first round. Against the number eight seed, Sung Ji-hyung, World Championship bronze medalist and twice a semi-finalist here in Japan, two straight games. So this is the fifth meeting between the two players. And though Li Xuerui, as you can see, holds the advantage, having won three of the previous four the last time they met, which was in the second round of the Indonesia Super Series earlier this year. As you can see, it was Yamaguchi who won in three games on that occasion, coming from a game down to win in Jakarta.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Akane Yamaguchi, Japan. my left, Li Xuerui, China.
Eric Kurth of Denmark is our umpire for this one. Seng Yeng Wen from Taipei, our service judge.
Love all. Play.
Now, that's sent a very clear message, hasn't it, from the defending champion.
One love.
Oh, that's a nice skill. Quite a difference in height between these two athletes.
Service over.
Xuerui, 173. Yamaguchi, 156. No, oh, that's two body smashes in the first three rallies.
Two.
From Xuerui. The tallest of athletes, but my goodness, she's quick around the court. Look how early she took that
four,
at the net.
Three.
Yamaguchi. Dictating the pace completely, Yamaguchi.
Six, three.
And the disguise punch clears, getting Li Xuerui off balance. Would you believe it?
Four, six.
Well, you can see knees heavily strapped from Li Xuerui. Yeah. dictating the pace.
Service over. 7-4.
Gone long.
Eight, four.
Seven of the last 8 points. That's brilliant. Oh, it's called out. A challenge.
Akane Yamaguchi.
Yes, she's challenging.
Called out.
Well, I'm pretty convinced that landed in, but we'll wait for Hawkeye to adjudicate. No, it did look good from where I'm sitting, but Hawkeye's got a better view, and indeed it was good. Yep, and the fans love that.
Nine. Four. Play.
That's a nice shot.
Service over. 5-9.
Going wide. Well, she's really not giving the Olympic champion time to settle within the rallies.
10-5.
She's not only dictating the pace, she's playing at a terrific pace as well. High tempo. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. And a 6-point advantage at the mid-game interval for the former champion, the 18-year-old Akane Yamaguchi. Absolutely extraordinary. 10 of the last 12 points because she was 1-3 down. That's one of the advantages, I suppose, of being a little shorter. You're able to play shots like that.
Court one,
around the head shot, as we
one,
call it.
20 seconds.
Just missed it, just overdone it, but my goodness me, her pace of movement.
11.
Yamaguchi, extraordinary. Well, obviously the Olympic champion is feeling under pressure. Trying to go for the lines and in 12, trying to do that.
Six.
She's making one or two errors. To me, it looked like a desperation shot. Doesn't know what to try.
14-6. over. 7-14.
Well,
eight,
she might live
14.
To regret that. Had her opponent under an awful lot of pressure, did Yamaguchi, and then made a simple error on the net shot. Yeah. Reverting to using the body smash. She used two of those in the first three rallies. Another one very effective. Straight out to her opponent.
The umpire on court three is Eishi Yamaguchi of Japan. And the first judge is David Wong of Malaysia.
Great disguise. Open the shoulders, big swing. Looked as if it was going to be a smash. I know it was barely half court, but still the disguise to play that little drop shot. Very good indeed.
Service over. 10-15.
Oh, super.
11-15.
Yeah, did well, did the defending champion. Swayed her body out of the way to give herself the freedom to play that forehand defense. Nicely done. Disguise drop shot once again from Yamaguchi. Good judgment.
Service over. 12-17.
Senses that all the fans here in the Metropolitan Gymnasium are all focused on this centre court. Only home player playing at this precise moment.
What? Service over. 13-18.
Points from this opening game. she's just not reading which way the 19, shuttle's going to come.
13.
Having to wait and then react. No anticipation at all from the Olympic champion.
Service over. 14, 19.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah, it was better movement from Liu Xuerui.
15-19.
This movement here, yeah. More balanced, more controlled. And therefore, the opportunity to play the shuttle wherever she wanted to. That's good too. That's clever, clever play.
16-19.
Greeted with almost silence from the fans. That's great placement, isn't it? No, oh, there's just 2 points in it now.
17-19.
Six of the last 7 points to the defending champion, and she's right back in it. It's gone wide as well. Now there's just 1 point the deficit.
18, 19.
Wow, it looked like a foregone conclusion at one stage, didn't it? 6-14 down. 11-18 down. And now she's back level.
19,
great
four.
Fighting spirit from the defending champion, Li Xuerui.
Oh.
My goodness, how badly she needed that point, the home player.
Game point 19.
Game point opportunity. It's gone wide. And the opening game to the former champion, Akane Yamaguchi. Well, a great effort from last year's winner, Li Xuerui, in coming back from 11-18 to level things at 19-all, but it wasn't enough. And Yamaguchi, the opening game, 21-19 in 19 minutes. Yamaguchi's coach there, Shoji Sato. He was a magnificent men's singles player, wasn't he? 14 singles titles throughout his career, 3 consecutive All-England quarterfinals, including coming through the qualifying in 2007. Yeah, those are court officials, as I was telling you earlier. Eric Kirk from Denmark and Seng Ying Wen from Chinese Taipei. Mind you, Liu Xuerui's coach wasn't too bad a player, was he? A former world champion,
one,
Chen Jin.
One,
I wonder if we'll get a look
seconds.
At him. No, he's already back in his coaching chair. Here he is.
Second game.
World Championships in Paris in 2010. That's when he won his gold medal.
Play.
Not to mention an Olympic bronze medal as well to his name. So here we go, game number two. Ooh, that's an ominous start. Error on the serve. Well, it'll be interesting to me to see whether Yamaguchi is able to continue the sort of intensity and the speed of movement that she showed in the opening game. My word. Brilliant!
Service over. 3-1.
Oh, it was an extraordinary rally. Just like the counter-attack. Very good at it, too.
2-3.
Oh, that is superb. What a shot.
4-3.
Terrific rally. Oh, she's pushed it long.
5-3.
Idea. The reverse slice.
4-5.
Trying to angle it down cross court. That's a great clip. Yeah.
Well, six,
wry
four.
Smile from Yamaguchi. It was the clear that really did the damage and set up the rally. Shuttle got deflected by hitting the top of the tape.
6.
Ordinary slice, then the reverse slice. Great variation. Yeah, and that's good reactions too.
8-5.
Instinctive play. Didn't have time to think about it. Look at this. Well, I was going to say straight at her body. I think it was actually aimed more towards her head. Look at that reaction. And to be able to control that as well. That is fabulous. Hey! I'm just sensing a change in momentum here.
9-5.
Sato, Coach Sato, not looking too alarmed at the moment. But he'll certainly have one or two things to say here at the mid-game interval. On a run of 5 straight points. Has a 6-point advantage, does the defending champion. Yeah, this is 11-5 at the mid-game interval of game number one, but in game number one, it was in favor of Yamaguchi.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Good retrieving. Oh, quick. That's unbelievably fast. And you've got so many options when you take it early at the net.
That's
an incredible shot.
13-7.
It seems to be able to play it flat and fast when not necessarily taking it that early. No, just missed it.
14-7.
Well, looks as if we're, in all probability, going to be treated to a third and deciding game. That said, Li Xuerui was 6-14 down the opening game, got back to 19-all. You never know.
8-14. It's over. 15-8.
Yes. Oh, the great disguise, look at that.
9-15.
Right until the last moment, you thought she was going to hit the smash. Yeah, it's a little bit of luck for Li Xuerui. Great judgment. Ooh. Well, there's a challenge here from Li Xuerui. Now, Hawkeye will adjudicate. But you to challenge. Ooh, that's plumb on the line. Gracious. What a great challenge from Li Xuerui. Far side of the court.
9. Play.
Good follow-up. When you know you've hit a good first smash, you know that it's virtually impossible for your opponent to get the defensive shot right to the back of the court, and therefore you follow forward. Oh, that is magnificent. What a lovely straight slice smash. Well, 2 points away from levelling this quarterfinal at one game apiece. Does she do that? Well, I guess an awful lot of it is getting yourself in position. And your overhead shot, the start of it looks exactly the same, and then you throw in the reverse angle, the reverse slice. 8 game point opportunities now to level this at one game apiece. Oh, a little bit of trickery there from Yamaguchi.
20.
One game apiece.
Second game won by Lee Xuerui,
21-13. One game all. 36 minutes, and in essence, we're back to square one. Well, great fight back by the Olympic champion. You'd expect that, wouldn't you? And that is a brilliant way to close out the second game. Yeah, the whole body movement then, the turn of the shoulders, exactly the same as when she hits it straight down the line, but just rolls that racket head at the last moment to send it across court. And it's wonderful to watch.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
The call of 20 seconds. From the umpire, a clear indication that players should come back on court.
Final game. Love all. Play.
So third and deciding game. Defending champion against the former champion.
One love.
Well, I think the start to this deciding game of utmost importance, especially to this youngster. Needs to make a good start. Needs to keep with her opponent in the early stages. Of the importance, not only for your own well-being psychologically, but the importance of making a good start to this deciding game is to get the crowd involved once more from Yamaguchi's perspective. Yep, four straight points. Slicing across the feathers of the shuttle. Oh, there's a challenge. It was called in. She was right over the shuttle. Well, she's made one challenge already and she was correct on that. So still has the two challenges left. And I have my doubts about whether she's right on this one. No, it did catch the line, it was in. So she loses a challenge now.
Service over. 5-3. Play.
Yes, and the crowd are very much playing their part now.
6-3. Akane Yamaguchi challenges fourth out.
Well, Hawkeye once again asked to adjudicate. I thought that was a correct call by the line judge. But we'll wait for Hawkeye. Yeah.
Challenge unsuccessful.
Line judge was correct.
One challenge remaining. Service over. 4-6. Play.
Well, she knows she's got to play the perfect net shots because otherwise Yamaguchi, she's been so fast coming forward and she's played such variation from the front of the court that you really have to make it almost impossible for her to get it back.
Service over. 6-7.
Did she get up as well? It's going wide. Well, I think she must have changed her mind.
7-9.
Anywhere over and in. And that would have been an outright winner. Goodness me. She can't allow that missed net shot to play on her mind. Yamaguchi, got to refocus.
Ah!
That's a good rally. What a backhand. Oh, my goodness! What a smash!
Service over. 10-8.
Well, the counter-attack from Yamaguchi has been superb today. And that was another example. And she has a three-point advantage as they change ends in this third and deciding game. What a match. What a quarter-final. And it's utterly astonishing to think this is her fourth Japan Open. Yamaguchi, and it's the first time she hasn't had to play through the qualifying.
Court one,
that's
20
amazing,
seconds.
Isn't it?
Court one, 20 seconds. Thank you.
In fact, came through the qualifying in 2012. That was her first ever Super Series event, lost in the first round. Then a year later, in her second Super Series event, came through the qualifying, 2013, won the title. Last
11,
year, she started
eight.
In the qualifying. Got through the qualifying, lost in the first round to her opponent of today in three games. 21-18 in the deciding game.
Well,
home fans will be hoping that history doesn't repeat itself as far as Xuerui beating Yamaguchi is concerned. Good thought process. Delicate little change of pace there by rolling the racket head, playing it cross court.
9.
Goodness. Well, the dive just got up incredibly quickly, but not quickly enough. Look at this. Up she gets. Ah, that's good, clear thinking from Xuerui. Most players would have had to hit that straight. Pressure is building on the defending champion.
14-10.
See much better than that.
11-14.
The crispness of shot, the acute angle, the wonderful placement. That shot from Xuerui had it all. rally. Oh my goodness. The refusal to give in from Yamaguchi. She was doing all the chasing in that rally. And the final net shot, 15, the error 11. From Li Xuerui. General rule, the flat fast exchanges tend to suit the shorter players.
16,
easier
11.
Just to crouch down and hit the shuttle back, so I'm surprised at the Olympic champion getting embroiled in that sort of rally. And what a perfect serve. Ever closer
18,
to her goal.
11.
3 points away from victory over the defending champion. Oh, what a net shot. Short lift. Oh my goodness, don't believe it. Yamaguchi, that utter refusal to let the shuttle die.
19-11.
Unbelievable.
Service over, 12-19.
She's missed it.
13-19.
Yeah. Big puff of the cheeks there. Big gulp of air. Calm yourself down. Valiant attempt to get back from a huge deficit in the opening game, almost made it. Well, she did get back level at 19 all, but still lost that opening game. So this is not a foregone conclusion. But now, the 18-year-old Japanese youngster has six match point opportunities. Second match point goes a begging. Yeah, there was a 16, audible 20. Gasp from the crowd there.
Premier Super Series earlier this year, and now on home soil beats last year's champion in three thrilling games.
By Akane Yamaguchi, 21-19, 13-21, 21-16.
4 minutes shy of the hour mark. My goodness mate, what a performance from Yamaguchi. Well, she caused a sensation 2 years ago when she won the title as a qualifier. I think as far as results and way she won this match today, to me, that was even more impressive. What a talent she is. Confirmation of the score, 21-19, 13-21, 21-16 in the deciding game.
So with three of our five quarterfinals completed, next we can look forward to the second of our men's singles. So who will Chao Tien Chen play in tomorrow's semi-final? Will it be Victor Axelsen, the young Dane, or the qualifier, Lee Dongkyung? Then, of course, we'll have men's doubles, and Endo and Hawakawa, fresh from their bronze medal at the recent World Championships. They're up against Kim and Kim from Korea, who were bronze medalists at the previous two World Championships. So a high quality men's doubles to finish off our quarterfinals day here in Tokyo.
Well, as far as the men's singles is concerned, this second match we're about to witness is from the bottom half of the draw. The Olympic champion, Lin Dan, who beat Li Chongwei yesterday,